IMT. So just one thing I did want to show you. You know, we keep talking about you get a flow study. This is the common carotid. That should be what the internal and external. This is the bulb. So hemodynamically, anytime you have a fork in the road, you're going to get turbulence. Quite often you're going to get, if you're going to get a discrete plaque, you're going to get it here. Here is the intima, this white, thin white line. Here's the media, the muscle layer, the thicker white line, and that's the distance. We take a flat space of at least a centimeter. That's part of what Laura's having to do back there. She has to know how to find your anatomy, how to find a good flat place in your common carotid so they can do this. They then have technology which will go in, take 600 cuts, not physical cuts, cuts in the image, and measure them, and that is what will show your arterial age. So as you see up here, the external carotids go into muscles in your face, your internal carotids what's going to your brain. And for most of it, most of us, the internal carotid is a bigger artery. For those of us that it isn't, no comment. A landmark study is called the Cafe's Decave study. To cut right to the chase, here are the people that this makes a big difference about. We always knew if people didn't have plaque, they weren't at risk. We always knew if people had, if you have plaque impacting your flow, you know those, for every one CIMT you can find, there's at least 300 or 400 regular ultrasounds, which people keep bringing in to me thinking they've got a CIMT. They're looking at that. And if they have a positive on that, here, on this one, if they have a positive on this, their 10-year event rate is 80%. So this is without treatment. Don't panic. But here's where I fell, and here's where a whole lot of people fall. You think you're doing great, and you've got no impact on your flow study, but we do a CIMT, and sure enough, you have plaque. 40% event rate over the next 10 years. Are you feeling lucky? Again, don't panic. That's untreated. And that's why the Cafe's Decay study will obviously never be repeated. I'll just skip over that. Discrete plaque right there. Again, it's in the bulb. It's where we're most likely to see it. I've got 3 or 4 hours worth of videos, free videos for you or anybody else out there with one of the world's experts. He's played a big role in this. He actually graduated. He got a doctorate in healthcare quality, and that's the big bugaboo with this, trying to make sure, or making sure that you're getting the exact same view, the same cut. So you've got to make sure that these folks are very, very good. And she is. Laura's actually Brad's niece, by the way. I met her through Brad. So he's very good. Todd Eldridge is very good at making sure these people do the right job every time, and it's comparable to other people doing the same job. This is a slide I borrowed. I don't know how to do that kind of transition stuff, but the bottom line again is it's the folks that already have impact on their flow, they're in serious trouble, and most of them already know it. The surprises and the real value that you get from this is when you didn't have an impact on flow, these guys. This is mine, I think. So, big surprise, I went in, I got my first CIMT at age 57, expected to do some victory laps because I've always practiced what I preach in terms of healthcare. I thought I was a poster boy for health, for lifestyle. As I've mentioned, I've got some epigenetic challenges and some genetic challenges too. And I probably should have been taking, I lost 10 pounds. I added a statin. The statin haters out there, I know. I was too, and I still am, but I added a statin. And if you look in the science, here's the thing. one of the, it isn't well known. You can see significant drops in plaque when you've got two things. Somebody that's virgin to statins, they've never had statins before, and number two, their plaque is less than 3 years old. So we were having a conversation about this last night, and Doug was saying, well, how'd you know that your plaque was less than 3 years old? Well, I actually started developing hypertension about a year and a half before that. Okay, I am going to take five more minutes. I'm sorry, I do want to make this one thing. Yes?
Hey, Mark.
With the new calibration of the instrumentation through your new group here, did your CIMT test change?
Get worse. I just blitzed through that. You ever heard about, the hospital's got a new MRI, it's got a 4 Tesla instead of 1 or 2. I don't know that stuff very well. Some of your tech guys may. You ever heard of that? Technology marches on, machines get better and better and better. Todd made an adjustment in his machines which made them far better at picking up plaque, about a year and a half ago. And it just rippled right through my population because everybody said, I got a huge increase. Well, I did too, and I got used to talking them down out of a tree. And that's actually what happened to John Lorscheider. He got a big increase, despite the fact that he'd lost 40 pounds, he'd gone from having a blood sugar routinely up in the 200 and 300 area, down to 100 or less, and his CIMT looked like it went up. And in fact, that's why I went ahead and said, well, darn it, I'm just gonna get another calcium score. So, nothing is that simple, is it? Here's the problem with CIMT, and here's why it's so hard. Here's what Laura's so good at. Everybody, once you see that picture, you realize perspective matters, doesn't it? And here's what we're wanting to look at. We're wanting to see, make sure. So when I take the wand, the ultrasound wand, I actually trained in this, but it never got good enough to do it. Don't trust me if I try to do it for you. You see the plaque on the back side of the artery. Well, obviously, if they came in from here, that's a very different number from coming in from here. And that's the problem with getting a good CIMT. Did you want to go to the intense experience in Louisville but just didn't have that kind of money or time? Take a look. We've got another one coming up in Orlando, February 28th. There's a way to save a lot of money on it, as much as 50% off. Take a look.